This is the beautiful Tana Delta region of Tana River County. The Tana Delta wetland in this area covers approximately 163,000 hectares and is home to both marine and terrestrial species. Residents of Kipini village, situated in the Tana Delta wetland, are highly dependent on fishing as their source of livelihood. Kipini village is at the center of the meeting point of the Tana River and the Indian Ocean. Local communities here depend on the mangrove for timber and fuel. Continued destruction of the mangrove cover and uncontrolled exploitation of these resources has devastated a large portion of the Tana Delta ecosystem.
We should have started conserving the Tana River long time ago. We should have started putting in place management plans for this Tana River years ago. Because if we do not do it, then we can see the red lights flashing.
Residents of Kipini are now living in fear of their village getting submerged should heavy sea waves hit the area.
Kama ingewezekana hapa Kipini, huu ukingo wa bahari, yani tujengewe ukingo, ambao yani maji hayangeweza kutoka kule, ili manake sahi ni kama hii milima yote imeliwa na maji. Na tahadhari yetu ni kwamba hii milima ikitoka hayo maji yatatuvamia hapa kwetu mjini.
Human encroachment here is also threatening the existence of marine species including fish that had for years served as the major source of livelihood for area residents.
Haya maji yetu ya mtoni vile yanavyotoka kule juu, zile chemicals ambazo huwa zinawekwa huko kwa haya maji ndio inafanya hata hawa samaki wetu kuwa wanakimbia juu. Hata kuna samaki wengine ambao hawaonekani kabisa.
We need to talk to the people upstream. We need to make sure that the agricultural practices that they are using are sustainable, not only in terms of how they use the soil but also in the chemicals they use.
Environmentalists are now warning that unless proper intervention measures are taken to safeguard the ecosystem from human destruction, its delicate natural balance will be wrecked beyond recovery.
There's too much utilization of the resources around the river, and we know, even as we come down here where we are staying at the Tana River Lodge, you can see a lot of the destruction that has happened because most of the vegetation that used to be around the river has actually been removed.
Environment conservation organizations Wetland International Kenya and Worldwide Fund for Nature WWF have embarked on various projects to save the ecosystem. Unless proper measures are put in place to save the ecosystem, its existence will soon be a thing of the past. Ahmed Jumabalo, Channel One Weekend.